Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. I allow Salah, I allow Salah, I allow Allah, I allow Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'gfiruhu. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati amalina. Min yahdi Allah fala mudilla lah wa min yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashadu an la ilaha illallahu Wadhu la sharika lah, wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ataku Allah, haqqa tuqatihi, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Ya ayyuha nas, ataku rabbakum, alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida, wa khalaqa minha zawjaha, wa batha minhuma rijalan kathirin wa nisaa. Wataku Allah, alladhi tasa'aluna bihi wa arham, inna Allaha kana alaykum raqiba. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, wataku Allah, wa kulu qawlan sadida, yuslih lakum amalakum, wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum, wa min yuti Allah wa rasuluhu, faqad faza fawzan azima. The translation: verily all praise is for Allah. We seek His help and ask His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of our own souls and from the mischief of our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides will never be led astray. And whomsoever Allah leaves astray, no one can guide. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah, one and alone, and without any partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a slave servant of messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except in the state of Al-Islam as Muslims. O mankind, reverence your guardian Lord, who created you from a single soul, created of like nature His mate, and from them twain scattered countless men and women. Fear Allah, through whom ye demand your mutual rights, and reverence the wombs that bore you. Surely Allah is ever watches over you. O ye who believe, fear Allah, and always say a word directed to the right, that He may make your conduct whole and sound, and forgive you your sins. He that obeys Allah and His apostle has already attained the highest achievement. As for what follows, before I begin, brothers, would you fill in the rows? Brothers, would you fill in the rows, please? Please. Muhammad Yusuf, Saeed, fill in the rows, please. Inshallah, I have something, inshallah. First of all, I'd like to say it's an honor and a privilege and a great responsibility to stand before you. So I have, inshallah, what I say is I think it's pretty good. Allah blessed me to put together something. The Imam has always said to show him what I know. So inshallah, I'll show you what Allah has blessed me to understand, inshallah. I was going to look at a few words in the Quran, Arabic words in the Quran, and analyze them and see how they fit together. First one of the words is qadr, qadr. The next word is hudda, or huddin. The next word is mizan. And then we have the word tatgail, tatgail. We have the word wazn, Hakimu Wada'a Furkan and Kasara. And Kasara. So we're looking at these words. And I know this is probably a little bit more of a talim than a khutbah, but inshallah, maybe that'll prompt some of us to come out a little bit more on Sunday. And we should have a Quranic study class. The Christians are wise to have a Bible study. They are wise to do that. And we have the better book, the pure book, so we should do that ourselves. We should have our Quranic study class. So on Sunday, the children in learning they're learning the Arabic, we decided to work on the Surah Ar-Rahman. And I told them that if they learn the whole surah, memorize, if you can recite the whole surah, I'll give them some money. And we advise all of you to maybe pitch in so they can do that. And then if they learn the actual meaning of all the words, that'll be some more money. As a teacher, I'm also learning always. I'm also learning. As I try to find out ways for the students to learn it and get it, that makes me look closer at what what I'm teaching. And that way I learn myself more about the topic. Now we know Surah Rahman, there are many pairs in it. So much so that it's called the Surah of Duality. Many pairs. And we know it's numbered 55. So we say, well, that's a pair right there. So what I did was this. Because that sounds good, but what I did also was I looked back to see in what order were the surahs revealed. And it would have been nice if it would have been 11, 22, 33, matched like that. But it was actually number 97. But still, that still doesn't, but again, Allah, who has power over all things, it was His determination that it would be compiled for that surah to be number 55, balance. Now, consider the title itself, Ar-Rahman. We know it goes with Ar-Rahim. So that's a pair right there. Now, I teach Arabic on Sundays, and when I go out to Fajr prayer, right now we and some brothers are trying to learn a little bit of Arabic. So we're talking about Ar-Rahman and Rahim. And I was a bit surprised to know that they did not know the difference between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. Maybe you don't know the difference. Imam Muhammad made it clear. And I think it's generally understood. What is the difference between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim? First of all, you hear Ar-Rahman with an N at the end. Rahman with an N at the end. And the other one is Ar-Rahim. It doesn't have that N. They both have Rahama, but the one has Ar-Rahman. And the other one just has without the N. So what's the difference? Imam Muhammad has said that the difference is, and I know most of you know, that he says that Ar-Rahman is a general mercy for everyone. Everything gets God's sunlight. Everything gets his air, his clean air. Everything gets everybody can see. Everybody can smell the flowers. But the Rahim is reserved for the believer. Rahim is reserved for the believer. It's a special mercy. So again, the criminal, he can kill somebody and then grab the flowers and give it to the parents. Okay, he's a criminal. He kills the body. Here's your flowers. So he can do that, but he doesn't get that special mercy. He'll get a punishment. Now we're going to look. Now the whole surah is powerful, very powerful, of course, as every ayat in the whole Quran is powerful. But we're going to focus on three ayats: number 7, number 8, and number 9. Now those three ayats. We're going to look at, there are six words within those three ayats that are paired together. There's a pair right there. Three times two, there's two, this gives you six. So in those three surahs, there are pairs of words that are very closely related. They're very closely related, But at the same time, again, there's a distinction. And that's where the precision lies. That's where the precision lies. Inshallah, you can give the cell phones a rest, inshallah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Again, these words, as you see, will see, are very similar in meaning. But the blessings is in the wisdom. The blessing is in the wisdom to know the difference. All right, I'm going to read surahs, ayats 7 through 9. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I'll read the other ayats first and then we'll get to that. Ayat 1. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ar-Rahman. Alama al-Quran. Khalaqa al-insan. Alama hu al-bayan. Ashamsu wal-qamru bi-husban. Wa-najmu wa-shajru yasjudan. The translation, Ayat 1. The Most Gracious. It is He who taught the Quran. He has created man. He has taught him speech. The sun and the moon follow courses exactly computed, and the herbs and the trees, both alike, bow in adoration. Now, the ayat, it says, Wasama'a rafa'aha wa wada'a al mizan, ala tatgal fil mizan, wa kimu waznal bilkist, wa la tuksiru al mizan. Now, it says, Ayat 7, and the sky, He has raised it. He had raised it high. And the sky, He has raised it high. Okay? And set up the balance. Allah says, He has raised up the sky. Now, actually, it was better to say that He has erected it. He has stacked it. He has stacked it in a particular way. Particular way, He has stacked it that way. Now, if you look at diagrams on the internet about the different levels of the atmosphere, they'll tell you, it is shown, they've shown different ones, different sources tell you they're between as little as 4 and as high as 8 different levels. Most of them, the majority, say about 5 or 6. Now, we know Allah mentions in the Quran what? There are 7 heavens, right? We know He says the 7 heavens a few times. What is curious that a most important level is not included in most of these, there are some estimations, and this as a distinct level, and that is the ozone layer. The ozone layer, that is not mentioned as one. They put it as part of the stratosphere. They put it as part of the stratosphere. But again, we know nowadays that the ozone layer is very, 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 very critical. Of course, also they don't mention, some of them don't mention the ionosphere. That would give us the 7. But again, as far as the ozone layer, we know that it says in 1976, atmospheric research revealed that the ozone layer has been depleted by chemicals released by industry, mainly CFCs or chlorofluorocarbons. Concerns that increased UV, ultraviolet radiation due to ozone depletion threaten life on Earth led to the ban of these. This was in 1976. Chemicals and the latest evidence is that ozone depletion has slowed or stopped. So now, because we were wise to see that, now we have stopped that. All right. Now, again, the level, these different levels are not equal in height, right? They're not equal in height. Some of them, they vary in depth. The lowest one, the troposphere, the one we're in, it goes up to only 7 miles high. The exosphere, exiting, it goes up, is 5,760 miles deep. So one is as little as 7, and one is a little, and one is as thick as 5,000, almost 6,000 miles. But Allah has determined the graduation of this. He has stacked it the way He wants to stack it. And we, for what purpose? We don't know. Allah says in Ayat 8, it says again, first of all, Ayat 7 says again, وَسَمَاءَ رَفَعَهَا وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانَ, and he has stacked the atmosphere, وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانَ, and we'll get to that, and he has set up the balance. So again, he's telling you what the balance is. It's not all 50-50-50, or it's not all 200 miles, 200 miles. He has set up, he has told you what the balance is. You understand? Something isn't always 50-50. He's telling you what the correct balance is supposed to be for the heavens. Ayat 8 says, in order that you do not transgress the balance, Allah tatgal fil mizan, so that you do not go wrong in this balance. So look, we was going wrong. But the ozone layer was being depleted. So we was depleting this level. He's trying to warn you right here that he has set up the correct balance and how much should be in these levels. And they're looking to say, oh, this is thinner than we thought it should be. So the scientists understood. Maybe we need to go back and check these out. So for our own very survival and our own very safety, we're following what Allah has set up. Allah says, Ayat 9, وَاكِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْكِسْتِ وَلَا تُكْسِرُ الْمِيزَانِ. And again it says, so establish weight with justice and fall not short in the balance. All right. So with regard to the ozone layer, we know that we have corrected that and we stopped that. But again, we are still troubled with our atmosphere. And I truly believe that, I know some people don't, you know, unfortunately our administration doesn't believe that we are having climate change. And with all the rain we are beginning, that, believe me, the earth is trying to correct itself. If you think about it, we talk about the balance. It's a small balance between, again, how much does it take to start evaporating all the water? We're at that tipping point. So all that we say that the earth is three-fourths water, right? If it's three-fourths water, it wouldn't take much for just a little bit more evaporation to give us all this, the cover starts covering more of these coastal areas. So again, Allah has told you he has set up the balance, that you do not transgress the balance. So look, so now we're just going to analyze the pairs that I was talking about, the three pairs. Allah says, again, the first pair is mizan and wazan. Mizan and wazan. Same word, basically. The same word, the same root word. Wazana means to weigh. Wazana means to weigh, to judge, to balance. But which one do you think is more refined? Wazana or mizan? The word mizan is. Why is that? Because aslama means to submit, right? To submit. But when you are a Muslim, then you are one who has submitted. So again, when you put that meme in front of the meme on that word, that makes it more truer. So Allah gives us, he says, mizan and wazan. Again, the ayat says, it says, wasama'a rafa'aha. And the sky, the heavens, he has raised it. Wawada el mizan, and set up the mizan. Then he says, Allah tat gal fil mizan, that you do not exceed the balance. Then it says, Waqimu el wazna bil kist, wala tuksiru mizan. And it says, and set up the scale, wazan. The first one was mizan, the other one was wazan. Allah gives us the mizan. He gives us the perfect balance. That is His balance. He gives us the standardized balance that we need to know. It's the mizan. He gives us the mizan. You know, you say, well, how do they know how much an inch is, or a mile, or a foot? All these things, there's an international registry that tells you they agreed upon exactly what these things are. It is the mizan for that. You can't say, well, I say that's an inch. Well, that's not it. You can't do that. So Allah has given us the mizan so that we know what to follow. And he says, don't get out of the mizan in anything. So again, what is the difference? Again, the mizan is God's perfected or correctly calibrated balance. All right, it's his correctly calibrated balance. All right, now, the second group. Allah says, "What the group is Wada'a and Akimu." Wada'a and Akimu. Wada'a, what does Wada'a mean? That Allah says that he set this. Wada'a means to set, means to ready. It means to just have in perfect place. Allah says he is Wada'a. For you, he gives you Akimu. He tells you Wada'a means that he set it up. And when he sets it up, he's readied it. He's perfected it. But for you, he tells you Akim. So he's telling you to establish yours on what he has set up. Again, we say Akimu Salah, right? Akimu Salah, meaning prayer has been time to set, time to stand up on and pray. Prepare that the prayers are established and ready. But Allah says, Wada'a al Mizan. So the words are similar. See, all these pairs are very, very, very similar. Wazan and Mizan. About the same. But it's a slight difference. Mizan is Allah's perfected balance. But a wazan is a scale. Right? So as Allah says, use his balance to set up your scale. Wada'a, again, is what Allah has readied. He has put in place. He has set. So he tells you to Akimu. Akimu, set up and set close. Wada'a and Akimu is very, very close. But the details is where you find the perfection. Again, Wada'a and Akimu. Well, isn't that about the same thing? It is, but there's a slight difference. And finally, Allah says, "Wala tatgal fil mizan." And then he says, "Do not transgress the balance." And then for you, he says, "Wa kimu wazna bokis wala tuksiru el mizan." So for him, he tells you that he has set up the balance that you do not. But the word is. Tatgal means to exceed or go outside of the balance. Tatgal means to go outside of the balance. Well, isn't that the same as wala tuksiru? Tuksiru means to break or to be off. It says so. Establish weight with justice and don't fall short in the balance. So the words tatgal and kasra are very close in meaning. Tatgal means to exceed, to go outside the limits of, and kasra means to break or to be wrong. But it's the slight difference is what? Again, if you exceed the balance, whether too much or too little, you're going to break. You're going to end up with a broken situation. Again, the words are very close, but the details are in the beauty is in the details. Now, inshallah, again, let's recap before I finish for this part. Mizan and wazan. Mizan is Allah's perfected. Mizan is Allah's perfected scale by which we use our, we use our scale to measure ours to get to the mizan. Wada'a means Allah has set up something. And again, from that, we set up our procedures. Tutgal and Kusser. Tutgal means Allah says that you do not go outside of this. And if you do, you're going to have the Kusser. You're going to get broken. Now you might say, oh, that's real good. But what does that really mean? What good is that? There's great guidance in that. Consider this. I mentioned the word cutter, which means power, ability, destiny, right? We say, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. We say that's the night of power. Well, you know what? If you don't have this perfect, exact situation, Again, very detailed situation. Maybe you don't have any power. Maybe you don't have any power. Consider gasoline, right? Gasoline. I listened to a tape about by Henry Ford, and he was trying to make a very, very crude carburetor. How much gasoline would have mixed with air to cause the carburetor start working? And so to know these fine details, that's where the ability comes from. So again, we say, man, I drove here on fumes. I was totally out of gas. I made it here on fumes. But in reality, if you fill up your car and drive, you're driving on fumes. Did you know that? Because it has to take a perfect combination of gas and air and spark to get to make the explosion, right? And again, too much air is too lean or too rich, right? Too much gasoline, too rich. So it has to be a perfect. So you just can't say, I got some. You can't put a spark to gasoline and expect an explosion. It's too rich, right? So all this. So Allah tells you, for you to understand how the universe works is very critical. That's why I'm showing you how close these words are, so you can even have ability to do things. Consider also in your own bodies. This is very powerful. We have pairs of chromosomes, right? We have pairs of chromosomes. We have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Little things of matter that you can't even see, right? Microscopic, right? Now, what I tried to do when I had the students go through the Quran and see how many times it says, فَبِعَيِّ أَلَّا إِرَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Then which of the favors of your Lord will you deny? Right? That's the ayat. It's repeated over and over and over again. And it was 32 times. And something said to me, well, isn't that like something in our body? But actually, it's not 32, it's 23. But we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Allah has determined this. And the point is this. That shows what? That these numbers that Allah gives us, these numbers, this balance, these pairs, only Allah can do this. He has said, this is the mizan for inside your body. And they're pairs. Not just 23, but 23 pairs. Not 22, not 24, 23 pairs. Not, which come up to 46. Not 47, not 48, not 45. What happens when it's 47? Just one more chromosome. What happens when it's Down syndrome? Right? Your whole life is affected. Down syndrome. My brother passed away. He had severe Down syndrome. Just one more chromosome. Just one more something again that you can't even see without a microscope. So Allah has set up this perfect balance, 23 pairs. So when you kind of say, I don't know where he's going with this mizan and wazan, and where he's going with this with wada'a and akimo, and where he's going with this tadgal and kusr, that's where I'm going with it. These words are real, real, real close, but at the same time, they make a world of difference. And again, another word I mentioned was furqan. The furqan, the criterion. That word means criterion. Okay, and then the root word is Faraka, means to separate. Faraka means to separate. Furqan, Allah tells you exactly where to separate things. The furqan, or the criterion, he tells you where to separate things. So again, so knowing and adhering to these words and following these words and getting guidance for these words gives us what? Gives us the huddin. He gives us the guidance. You understand? That's one of the words, huddin. He gives us guidance. He tells, or your very life can be at jeopardy. Right? He tells us, how much is the average temperature that we're supposed to be? 98.6, right? That again, you go up too high, or you have a fever. You go down too low, something is wrong. Another point, real fast. They're selling what they call alkaline water, right? They're selling what they call alkaline water. Do you know that your blood is pH is 7.2, very critical. Water, pure water is 7.0. So when they try to tell you this alkaline water is as high, I've heard it said as high as 9 or something like that, that's just trying to sell you something. Because you know what, if your water, if you ever taken something that's 9, you're drinking cleaner. They use cleaners that are very high alkaline and very low acidic. So when they try to, that's just sales. Your blood pH can't vary too much from that. 7.2. So all these critical things, Allah has set up these numbers. He has set up the mizan for you to, when you do your wazan, that you say, okay, I must compare it to the mizan. Pray for Allah's forgiveness. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So for the second part of the khutbah, I want to switch gears a little bit and talk about something. And again, so the whole point of it is again, know that Allah's criterion and His judgment and His balance are all very important in our lives. We should study our religion. Study it carefully. Don't let me and the people who study it have all the fun. Get enjoyment and get power out of studying this religion and knowing about this religion and knowing the wisdom in the Quran. So in this second part of the khutbah, I was in the military for 20 years. And I was in the intelligence. I was in the intelligence branch. So I'm going to say this before it gets too far out, okay? Before it gets too far out, it's called time sensitive. It's time sensitive, or what they call perishable information, meaning that if you get too far from it, what good is it, right? What good is it? So. Okay, so these last few weeks have been very powerful for our family. And a few weeks ago, my youngest son had his first son. Praise be to Allah. That's been about, I've been five or six weeks now. And I think Brother John, it's been 3 weeks since your celebration, and I'm kind of jealous. He had his 60th wedding anniversary, and it was a really big deal. It was really great. It was really, really, really great. And you see that how big of a deal Brother John really is. But he's low profile, but you see his family, and you see all the great accomplishments and all everything. It's really great. And just last week, we weren't here. This Saturday, we was down in Norfolk, Virginia. We attended a family reunion, and that we knew, that we've been knowing for like 40 something years. And these people are relatives of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad from Chicago. They're relatives of them. And also while we were there, we was with another family. And who knew you, Brother Imam? Who knew you? And I know Brother Michael. Brother Carlos Beyond? Brother Carlos. We had lunch with him. And so it was a great blessing. He actually showed us the same picture that you have of them going to Hajj. So it's great, powerful. But I would say what got me in to Brother John's wedding anniversary was what happened a few weeks ago. And that was my brother marrying his sister. So I guess I'm in the family now. So praise be to Allah. Allows me to get in on some functions. But that was very powerful. And this is what I want to say about that. Originally, I thought I was supposed to give the khutbah on that Friday. Originally, I thought I was supposed to give the khutbah. So I was preparing something. Okay? And but I'm glad Brother John did, because what he said was so profound about the family being, again, we talk about balance. Allah says, or the hadith says, that your marriage is 50% of your religion. 50%. That's a whole lot, right? And so he says, so we asked the question, well, what's the other 50%? He said, divorce. Divorce of what? Divorce of all the bad stuff that's going to mess up your religion, mess up your marriage. Right? So again, so keep your families together. So this is what I had. This is what I had prepared for what. So after I wasn't going to do it at the khutbah, I said, okay, I'll save it. I'll save it for the wedding itself. But I'm glad that didn't happen again, because what I was said is kind of a little bit too thoughtful. And at a wedding, they don't want to hear too much. You know, you have to put too much, you know, pay attention too carefully. So this is a good time to tell it. So, again, at my job, when I was in the military, and I hope I wasn't wasting your taxpayers' money, but we had a fantasy basketball teams. We was doing fantasy basketball teams. And my initials are J.A., and my teammates' initials was A.J. So someone, I don't think either one of us says, they titled our group the Mirror Images. Mirror Images. Okay? So, with that, the ayat, there was one ayat that I was going to talk about when I spoke. And again, the one that Brother John spoke about, and which is the perennial ayat, is ayat 4, I mean, Surah 4, ayat 1, about the Anissa, that he has spread countless men of women from one soul, right? The one I was going to say is 1985. Remember that. If you want to go back and look at it, it's called 1985. And I know it by heart. It's just a few words. Okay? And it says, Yoma Nashuru Amutakina Ila Ar-Rahmani Wafda. For those who know Arabic, think about it for a second. Yoma Nashuru Amutakina Ila Ar-Rahmani Wafda. Yom means day. Nashuru. We gather. The Na is us. We gather. Hashara means to gather. The Na is we. Hashara means to gather. So the day that we gather, Amutakina, those who have taqwa, Ila Ar-Rahmani Wafda, to the Rahman, to the most merciful. Here there's the word Ar-Rahman, Wafda. Wafda means what? A delegation, an envoy, or Yusuf Ali says, let me find it, what he says. He says, I like the way he puts it. He's very poetic. He gives the essence of the Quran. He really does. There's different translations, but I think Imam Muhammad said he also liked his translation. But it says, the day we shall gather the righteous to the most gracious, like a band presented before a king for honors. Now he adds that little bit like a band. The band is the wafta, presented before a king for honors. So that was the ayat I was going to talk about for the wedding. And that is what the purpose of marriage is, if you didn't know. What good is it if you have a great old time with your marriage partner, right? You're married, your husband and wife, and then what happens is that, but you're not spiritually inclined. And so you have all this fun. You have everything you ever wanted, and then what happens? And then you go to your Lord and say, wait a minute, you enjoyed your life in that world, but what about the next world? Or one of you is a Muslim and the other one isn't. And so the one that's a Muslim gets up and makes his prayer, but the one who isn't just rolls over, goes to sleep. One goes to hell, one goes to heaven. So what good is it if the person that you've been married to goes to hell? Right? So it says, Yoma Nashiru Amutakina Ila Ar-Rahmani Wafta. The day that we gather the Mutakin, those who have taqwa, to the Rahmani Wafta. Now you say, again, Yom means day, Nashru, we gather. Who is the we? Allah says, we gather, so it's Allah speaking that we're gathering the gathering. Our Mutakina ila Ar-Rahman. Who is our Rahman? Allah. So what is he saying? I am gathering the Mutakin to myself. I am gathering the Mutakina to myself. Again, Yoma Nashru, we gather a Mutakina Ila Ar-Rahman. I'm gathering the Mutakin to myself as a delegation. So look, on that Saturday between the Kutbah and that Sunday, which is the wedding, that Saturday, there was a cookout. And I had made some homemade ice cream, a lot of it, right? And I got there kind of late, so I had to hurry up and set up. So what did I do? So I had to tell some people, hey, I got some homemade, I had to go to them, tell them, I got some homemade ice cream, come and get it. So when they get there, who's serving it? I'm serving it. So that's the same thing. God says he gathers the Mutakin to himself. So I'm just thinking about that. You know what? I made the ice cream. I say, come on, get some of the ice cream. I got some of this ice cream. And when they get it, they get there and I'm the one serving it. Right? So it's the same thing. Allah has good for you, that he's gathering you to himself. Again, so here's the point that's powerful. I talked about J.A. and A.J. Well, my brother's initials are B.A. And Aisha's initials was A.B. Initial Bilal. His name, again, was B.A. Bashir Ali. And her name was A.B. Aisha Bilal. They came together. Right? And so the point of it is, when husband and wife, what are they supposed to do? They're supposed to be what? A mirror for each other, right? Just like I was in the military, AJ and JA, you understand? So they're supposed to be a mirror for each other. To do what? To do what? Check each other out. Check each other out. Looking before you step out, wait a minute, come back here. Why are your shoes messed up? Why are your shoes on shine? So again, when it says the day that the Mutakina are gathered to the Rahmani Rafta, here's a band going in front of them for their Lord, and we have somebody say, everybody look at each other. Wait a minute, your button is missing here. Your button is missing here. Your visor isn't shining. So they're checking each other out. So again, the Mutakina is doing this. The Mutakina, those who are the Mutakin, those are the righteous people. Only the righteous people can check other righteous people, right? They can only ones who can look in the mirror and see other righteous people. Allah says, I was looking up the word, Imam says, it says again, the day we gather. And who again, Imam Rauf tells us that we're talking about, what's the word? It's the empirical we. That's the word, the empirical we. When he says we, he's talking about himself. We say, we do this. And if you look in the Bible, they call it, they say, they use the term sometimes, the Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts. What does that mean? What's host? Armies. So basically, Allah said he's the commander of his forces. So when Allah says the Lord of hosts, he's talking about the commander of his forces. And what are the forces? He using the Mutakin to gather other Mutakin. So again, you're standing there and you're ready to walk out, but no, you're not ready. So the whole point of it, the best thing I can say about marriage is this. I have a mate who is going to get me ready to stand before my Lord. Again, you live in this world with somebody, what good is it? And again, one goes to hell, or you both go to hell, and the other one doesn't. So again, it's not just husband and wife, it can also be among families, right? The parents can tell the children, the parents, the whole band. The parents can tell the children. The children can tell the parents. No, let's get up. Let's make Fajr. Let's get up. Somebody calling the oldest son or the father's calling the Adhan. Let's get up. Let's get to heaven. I'm trying to check you out. I'm trying to get you there. Stand there. The day that the Mutakina, Yom Nasharu, that we gather, the Mutakina, Ila Ar-Rahmani Wafta, so they can get their reward. That's what marriage was going to say. That's what marriage is all about. That's what again, this life is short. The next life is forever. And again, you want to spur them, and I said, well, us in nansan lafikus. I'm sorry. Yeah, illadina amanu what to wasaw bil haq. You're spurring each other. Let's go. Let's do this. So praise be to Allah. That is what that is what I have for you today. And inshallah, again, don't just this hour be just a time I got to fill and just go on about, like the brother said last week, you know, we should have more spirit. Just come in and just go about your mundane life. Okay, I got to go to the store. I got to go pay the bills. I got to do this. And then, well, I just got to go make the Jummah. Okay, I got to go make the Jummah or whatever. Or I got to go see this movie. But still, your life is what? What is that? You need to be getting spirits. You need to be getting what Allah has for you. Study this Arabic. Know it. And know how much Allah is pulling you. He's pulling you. He wants you to get there. He has the paradise for you. And he wants you to get to it. Praise be to Allah. So I end. Okay, so I end with the ayats. Inshallah, I praise again that you got something from this. Again, study your Quran, trying to get the detailed understanding. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah says, Inna fi khalqi as-samawati wal-ard wa ikhtilafi al-layli wa nahara la'ayatin la'ulil al-albab. Behold, the creation of the heavens and the earth and the alternation of night and day. There are indeed signs for men of understanding. Alladhina yadhkuruna Allaha qiyaman wa qa'udan wa ala junubihim wa yatafakkaruna fil khalq samawati wal ard. Rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batilan subhanaka fakinna adhaban nar. Our Lord, men who celebrate the praises of Allah standing, sitting and lying down on their sides and contemplate the wonders of creation in the heavens and the earth with the thought, Our Lord, not for naught hast thou created all this. Glory to thee. Give us salvation from the penalty of the fire. Rabbana innaka min tutkili anara fakad akzaituhu wama lidhalimina min ansar. Our Lord, any whom thou dost admit to the fire, truly thou coverest with shame, and never with wrongdoers find any helpers. Rabbana Inna submitna munadiyan yunadi lil imani and amanu bi rabbikum fa amana. Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Our Lord, we have heard the call of one calling us to faith. Believe in the Lord, and we have believed. Our Lord, forgive us our sins. Blot out from us our iniquities and take to thyself our souls in the company of the righteous. Kadakami to Salat. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahmani Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'een, Ihdina Sirata Mustaqeem, Sirata Alladhina An'amta Alayhim, Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim, Walidhdallin. Bismillahi Rahmani Rahim. Ar-Rahman, Alama al-Quran, Khalaqa al-Insan, Alamahu al-Bayan, Ash-Shamsu wal-Qamaru bi-Husban, Wa-Najmu wa-Shajru yasjudan, Wa-Sama'a rafa'aha wa-Wada'a al-Mizan, Ala tatgal fil-Mizan, وَأَقِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُكْسِرُوا الْمِيزَانَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَضَعَهَا لِلْأَنَامِ فِيهَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ ذَاتُ أَكْمَامٍ وَالْحَبُّ ذُو الْعَصْفِ وَالرَّيْحَانِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. الله أكبر.
May Allah hula min hamadar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Ad-Din, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'een, Ihdina Sirata Mustaqeem, Sirata Alladhina An'amta Alayhim, Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim, Walad-Dallin. Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Kul Huwa Allahu Ahad, Allahu As-Samad, Lam Yalid, Wa Lam Yulad, Wa Lam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan Ahad. Allahu Akbar. Sami Allahu Lamin Hamadar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar.
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar.
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar.
We recite Al-Fatiha together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawm Ad-Din. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Sirata al-ladhina an'amta 'alayhim ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim